Today, most of us prefer to travel by various ways of transport: car, plane, boat, bus, horse, and train. Today, most of us prefer to go around town by bus or car than a train, and across our home continent by plane. And why? The answer is simple. Trains aren't fast enough due to friction. Friction is in fact why submarines move faster than a mining drill, a boat moves faster than a submarine, a car moves faster than a boat, a plane moves faster than a car, a bullet moves faster than a plane, the ISS moves faster than the bullet, and Voyager 1 moves faster than the ISS. Maglevs truly change my perspective of a train. Maglev trains hover above magnetic rails. Keep in mind that these are super strong magnets, since the maglev still weighs several tons. Now that's tons of weight. The maglev is attached to rails underneath, so that also has the benefit of being unable to derail while moving at the speed of an airliner. Maglevs are so far in service in Shanghai, Tokyo, Berlin, Birmingham, New York, and several other major cities. A normal drive in a 60-mile-an-hour car to the Shanghai airport can take up to 2 hours because of all the effing traffic. I mean, you know what happened on that highway in the summer of 2010, right? You'd be lucky to hit 60 miles an hour. On a 270-mile-an-hour or 435-kilometer-an-hour maglev, the trip only takes 5 minutes. In fact, some tests in Germany have reached speeds of 350 miles an hour or 570 kilometers an hour. But even at the non-test speeds, you could go from Paris to Moscow, New York to Denver, or Beijing to Hanoi in just 6 hours, covering 1,500 miles or 2,500 kilometers. On October 11, 2003, the Maglev Railway between Shanghai and its airport opened its doors to the public. And this 1 billion euro, I'm measuring in euros because this is surprisingly Germany's project, became the fastest railway in the world. Unfortunately, maglev trains are not fast enough to meet their construction costs, but we can easily make maglev trains much faster before the 22nd century is even around the corner. Using a new, much cheaper, and even faster type of maglev called vac trains. Maglevs already face the problem of air friction, and vac trains can solve that because they move in tubes with artificial vacuums inside. It's like traveling through deep space on Earth. Wait, what? Vac trains can easily reach speeds of Mach 3, or 2100 miles an hour, 3500 kilometers an hour. They can move from London, England to Tokyo, Japan in a mind-blowing, get ready for this, 3.5 hours. That's 6,000 miles, or 10,000 kilometers, in half a school day. At that rate, you could travel across a whole of the planet Earth, all 25,000 miles or 40,000 kilometers of it, in just 12 hours. And scientists and futurists say they'll be operational worldwide by 2090. 77 more years, though. But in the meantime, you can subscribe to KhAnubis Productions right here on YouTube. You can also suggest things for future videos in the comments, our Facebook page, or our Twitter page. It'll be much faster than the TGV.